hurricanes are among the most dangerous and destructive natural phenomena. These atmospheric giants are characterized by hurricane-force winds, torrential rains, and unparalleled destructive force that can destroy a city and cause significant flooding in coastal areas. They can also reach winds of several hundred kilometers per hour. Still, scientists and climatologists worldwide are observing that hurricanes have long seemed to be becoming more intense, frequent, and with faster winds. Could climate change be playing some role in this increase in hurricane intensity? Could it be that in the near future, hurricanes will exceed all existing categories and we'll have to invent a new classification for them? Are we close to facing super hurricanes? Stay with us to find out. What is a hurricane, and how does it differ from other similar phenomena? When we say hurricane, we are referring to a tropical cyclone. A tropical cyclone consists of a fast-rotating, low-pressure storm system that produces heavy rains and very fast wind gusts. Depending on its location and intensity, a tropical cyclone can be called a hurricane, typhoon, tropical storm, cyclonic storm, tropical depression, or simply cyclone. But in essence, it is the same kind of natural phenomenon, gigantic storms that form over the warm waters of tropical and subtropical oceans. Tropical cyclones suck in the air from a large area and concentrate the water content of that air over a much smaller area. This replenishment of moisture-containing air can cause hefty rainfall for several hours or several days up to 25 miles from the coast. This is far beyond the amount of water the local atmosphere can retain, which is why hurricanes can cause significant flooding. Hurricanes have existed for millennia. However, today experts suspect that they are becoming more frequent and intense. But to understand how this happens, let's look at how hurricanes form and work. Tropical cyclones tend to develop during the summer, but have been observed almost every month in most basins where they form. Hurricanes occur predominantly in tropical and subtropical regions, primarily in the North Atlantic, Eastern Pacific, and Western Pacific basins. Hurricane seasons vary by region, but are generally concentrated during the summer and fall, i.e., in the hottest seasons. Hurricanes usually form on either side of the equator, but the most common place they form is an area known as the intertropical convergence, where winds blow from the northeast or southeast. Within this vast area of low pressure, the air warms over the warm tropical ocean and slowly rises, causing stormy rains to form. These rains dissipate pretty quickly, however, they can be grouped into large groups of storms. This creates a warm, moist, and rapidly rising airflow. This constant flow of warm air and storms would remain like this for a long time until they dissipate. But they don't. Instead, little by little, the air and storms begin to rotate. Can you think of why these enormous masses of air and water would start spinning? Exactly. It's a consequence of the Coriolis effect. This is produced because water, air, and atmosphere are inside the Earth, which is in turn rotating on itself. Large masses of tropical storms are dragged by this rotational movement and begin to rotate in the form of giant eddies that end up forming hurricanes. However, because of this effect, hurricanes rotate in different directions depending on which hemisphere of the Earth they are in. For example, a hurricane in the northern hemisphere rotates counterclockwise, while a hurricane in the southern hemisphere rotates clockwise. Several factors are required for a hurricane to form, but the most important is a high sea surface temperature of at least 81 degrees Fahrenheit. Suppose we add this to the atmospheric instability, high humidity in the lower areas of the troposphere, sufficient Coriolis force, and a low-level focus or disturbance. In that case, it will indeed form a cyclone. If the cyclone continues to feed on more moisture, steam, heat, and water, it will become larger and larger, and therefore increase in category. The intensity of tropical cyclones is limited and strongly related to the temperature of the water along their path. An average of 86 hurricanes form annually worldwide. Of those, 47 reach a force of more than 74 miles per hour, and 20 become very intense tropical cyclones, at least Category 3 on the Saffir-Simpson scale. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Hurricane limits and how they will be overcome in the future. Hurricanes are classified according to the speed of their winds. The faster the winds, the higher the category. The most widely used measurement scale is the Saffir-Simpson, SSHWS, which gives us information about the wind speed of the hurricane. This factor is essential since the wind has a direct relationship with the size of the hurricane and the destruction it could cause once it makes landfall. Hurricanes are divided into five different categories. These are Category 1, winds of 74 to 95 miles per hour. Hurricanes of minimal intensity, primarily damaging trees, signs, and moving structures. Category 2, winds of 96 to 110 miles per hour. These are moderate hurricanes capable of causing significant damage to buildings, vehicles, and power lines. Category 3, winds of 111 to 129 miles per hour. These are major hurricanes that can cause devastating damage to homes, trees, and roads, and life-threatening coastal flooding. Category 4, winds of 130 to 156 miles per hour. These are extremely dangerous hurricanes capable of causing catastrophic damage to buildings, infrastructure, and landscapes, severe flooding, and the risk of loss of life. Category 5, winds over 157 miles per hour. These are catastrophic hurricanes that can cause total devastation in affected areas, including loss of life and extensive structural damage, such as destroyed homes and even collapsed buildings. Category 5 hurricanes are the most devastating and dangerous of all because they have high-speed winds and wind speed is usually linked to the size of the hurricane, so Category 5 hurricanes are also usually the largest. Throughout history, humanity has faced devastating hurricanes that have left an indelible mark on affected communities. Among the largest and deadliest are Hurricane Katrina, 2005. This powerful Category 5 hurricane struck the U.S. Gulf Coast, especially the city of New Orleans, causing catastrophic flooding and the deaths of more than 1,800 people. Property damage totaled tens of billions of dollars, making it one of the costliest natural disasters in U.S. history. Hurricane Haiyan, 2013. Known as Yolanda in the Philippines, Hurricane Haiyan was one of the most powerful tropical cyclones ever recorded. With winds reaching 315 kilometers per hour, it devastated much of the country's islands, killing more than 6,000 people and leaving millions homeless. Hurricane Mitch, 1998. Mitch was one of the deadliest hurricanes in the Atlantic, especially in Central America. It caused massive flooding and landslides in countries such as Honduras and Nicaragua, destroying bridges, roads, schools, and hospitals, causing the deaths of more than 11,000 people and leaving millions of families on the streets. All of these hurricanes were Category 5 hurricanes and caused impressive destruction. Can you imagine if there were hurricanes that exceeded this category? Something like a Category 6 hurricane or a super hurricane? Could a hurricane more intense than Category 5 ever form? The answer is yes, but this will require some essential conditions that some scientists say we are not far from seeing. Super hurricanes. Several atmospheric oceanic factors influence hurricane intensity, and the scientific community is intensely researching and debating their relationship to climate change. Although an absolute consensus has not yet been established, there are some trends and possible connections that have been observed in the increase in hurricane intensity. Some of them are 1. Seawater temperature. As mentioned before, hurricanes feed on the heat released by the ocean surface. As ocean waters warm due to climate change, there is a chance that hurricanes will become more intense and persistent, as they will have more energy available for their formation and strengthening. 2. Climate variability. Climate change can influence global weather patterns, affecting the frequency and intensity of hurricanes. For example, El Niño and La Niña events can alter atmospheric and oceanic conditions in the tropical Pacific, influencing hurricane activity in the Atlantic. 3. Sea level rise. Global warming contributes to melting glaciers and ice sheets, resulting in rising sea levels. This can increase the magnitude of storm surges associated with hurricanes, which can cause more severe and widespread coastal flooding. 4. Changes in precipitation patterns. Climate change can also influence precipitation patterns, affecting the amount and intensity of rainfall associated with hurricanes. Heavier rains can result in flash floods and landslides, increasing the risk of damage and loss of human life. Climatologists have observed that in recent years there has been an increase in the frequency of very intense storms, and a more significant presence of these in areas increasingly close to the poles. This could be due to a clear indicator that global warming is making hurricanes more intense and devastating. Could it be that we are close to witnessing a super hurricane? Recall that tropical cyclones use warm, moist air as fuel. As climate change warms ocean temperatures, hurricanes have more fuel available to grow and reach higher speeds. This can be seen in the Global Tropical Cyclone Record, which shows that between 1979 and 2017, the proportion of tropical cyclones of Category 3 and above on the Saffir-Simpson scale increased globally. Current models indicate that global ocean temperatures will continue to rise by at least 3.6 degrees Fahrenheit in the coming years. So a higher percentage, at least 13%, of tropical cyclones are expected to reach Category 4 and 5 strengths. Even some Category 5 cyclones could break the wind speed records established so far. If this happens, this new type of hurricane will no longer fall within Category 5 because it will be on a completely new scale. This could be what we at Insane Curiosity have decided to call super hurricanes, a new type of hurricane that would far surpass anything we've seen so far. Super hurricanes would be so large and destructive that Hurricanes Katrina, Haiyan, and Mitch would look like harmless blizzards by comparison. Can you imagine how much devastation a hurricane of that size would cause? These hurricanes would surpass Category 5 hurricanes in both size and wind speed, and therefore in the amount of devastation they could cause. They would be so large that they could enter the coast and advance several hundred miles before dissipating, causing great destruction in its wake, toppling buildings, ripping homes off their foundations, and causing flooding that would claim the lives of thousands of people. These would cause great concern in all coastal cities worldwide, as no country is prepared to face a natural phenomenon like this. While today there is no consensus on how climate change will affect the intensity of hurricanes, one thing is sure: climate change exists, and for years it has been increasing the intensity of several hurricanes. Your opinion is critical, so tell us, do you think we will see super hurricanes due to climate change? Let us know what you think in the comments.